What I think is really interesting about the U-2 is that it's been in service for so incredibly long. After World War II, the American government wanted to know whether or not the Soviets were building up their bomber fleet. So with the U-2, you can send it into an area where you want to get photos, and by nature of its being high-altitude flying, it's out of the reach of many air defense systems. One of the priorities of the design of the U-2 was in making it as light as possible. It's basically a glider with a jet engine. The original U-2s didn't have any paint because a coat of paint would add unnecessary weight, which would sacrifice altitude. And when you get up to altitude, it has to stay going in between certain speeds or else you're going to fall out of the sky. People had to wear pressurized suits because if you go higher than about 60,000 feet or so, any kind of liquid is going to boil, including your blood, but also your fuel will evaporate too. So a particular type of fuel was created for the U-2. Satellites still, currently, are unable to do the same amount of tasks with the time and with the precision that the U-2 can do. The U-2 has proven itself to be this incredibly versatile information gathering platform. It's one of only a handful of aircraft that has been in service for more than 50 years and continues to serve in missions to this day.